For the circuit shown in the figure, the transistors M1 and M2 are identical NMOS transistors, and it is given that to assume M2 be in saturation, then the current Ix is related to I bias as option A, Ix is equals to I bias plus Is, and option B, Ix is equals to I bias, option C, Ix is equals to I bias minus Is, and option D, Ix is equals to I bias minus VDD minus Vout divided by RE. It can be readily realized that this circuit is a current mirror circuit which replicates the current in this branch to this branch. So it can be established that I bias will be equal to Ix. But let us analyze from the given information. For NMOS transistor in saturation, the drain current ID is given by this formula. It is given that to assume that transistor M2 be in saturation, so I can write ID2 as, because here we have Ix, and ID2 can be expressed in this way. Now we have the transistor 1 in which the gate and drain are shorted. So this transistor M1 will be compulsorily in saturation region. Hence the ID1 can be represented in this form, that is 1 by 2 into Kn dash omega by L VGS minus VT whole square. We also have that these two transistors have same gate voltages because these two are shorted. So the currents IDs will be also equal because the gate sources are equal, and as the transistors are identical, this W by L will be same, this Kn dash will also be same, and VT will be same. We also have VGS same. So this ID1 and ID2 will be equal for these two transistors. But we have ID1 as I bias. This will be equal to ID2. Here we have Ix. The reason to write I bias as for the drain voltage is because these gates draw very less current. So this current will almost 99% will flow through this terminal. So I am writing ID1 as I bias. So the correct option will be option B.